Yes, I believe no permanent damage was done.
What happened?
The occipital area of my head seems to have impacted with the arm of the chair.
No, Mr. Spock, I meant, what happened to us?
That we have yet to ascertain.
Lincoln died 3 centuries ago on a planet hundreds of light years away.
More that direction, Engineer.
Thank heaven.
Mr. Scott, there was no deity involved. It was my cross-circuiting to be that recovered them.
How close will we come to the nearest Klingon outpost if we continue on our present course?
1 parsec, sir. Close enough to smell them.
That is illogical, Ensign. Odors cannot travel through the vacuum of space.
Opportunity? Now listen, Spock, you may be a wonderful science officer, but believe me, you couldn't sell fake patents to your mother.
I fail to understand why I should care to induce my mother to purchase falsified patents. Can you give me warp 8?
Aye, sir. And maybe a wee bit more. I'll sit on the warp engines myself and nurse them.
That position, Mr. Scott, would not only be unavailing, but also undignified.
I tell you, you better come on back down.
Krakos, put the bag on your captain.
Why would he put a bag on our captain?
Kidnapped him, you dope.
You realize that the aim will, of course, be very crude.
I don't care if you hit the broadside of a barn. Just hurry, please.
Captain, why should I aim at such a structure?
Never mind, Spock. Just get on with the job.